Peace be with you, everyone. This is Father Michael, along with the rest of the team, welcoming you to our chapel to pray. You're listening to the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 36, Love and the World. The standard of love is a high one. We all rebel and some are clueless. They are not just or truthful. They spend their time plotting to get ahead.
They plunder the world and do not share. I hate this, but I am not innocent. Though I try to share, to be just and frugal, most of the world points its finger at me.
Your love encompasses us all, strong like the mountains, deep like the sea. You give the priceless gift of life. We take refuge in the shadow of your wings, Lord.
We feast on the good things of the Spirit and see our aching world through your soft light.
Help us to find this happy place, to be true of heart and not so proud. Help us to live well and fairly, unseduced by the wickedness around us.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Christian community of Corinth. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 8 through 10. Three times I begged the Lord about this, that it might be taken away from me. And he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for virtue is perfected in weakness. And so willingly shall I glory in my weaknesses, so that the virtue of Christ may live within me. Therefore I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and distresses for the sake of Christ. For in my weakness I find my strength." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I cannot tell you how this one small passage in the Scriptures has impacted my life. Time and time again, I have, like St. Paul, gone to the Lord, begging, pleading, petitioning, bargaining for one thing or another, only to find myself disappointed, angry, upset, and hopeless because I thought I knew better than God. You know, I've been a Catholic all my life. I went to Catholic schools for all of my education. Back then, they were less expensive. They had the highest standards of education. And they were very Catholic in their identity. In grade school, I was formed by Dominican nuns from Springfield, Illinois, Sisters of St. Joseph of Condillet and Sisters of Loretto. When it came time for high school, I went to Regis Jesuit High School here in Denver and was able to pay my own tuition by working in the summer and after school. It was in high school when I first discovered all those negative things Paul mentions in this passage, the hardships, the insults, the disappointments of life. But it was also the place I discovered a growing relationship with Christ and began to become more interested in God calling me to serve. At the suggestion of one of my Jesuit professors, I found a spiritual director and began to discern what this call was to serve, I began to wonder if I was smart enough, disciplined enough, faithful enough, good enough to pursue this invitation by the Lord and enter into a deeper relationship with Jesus. As my spiritual director and I explored these things, one day he introduced me to this passage from 2 Corinthians, and with it, the Suscipe prayer by St. Ignatius, which I've shared with you before. You see, it was my introduction to a lifelong journey of relying on the Lord and coming to realize that His love and His grace are sufficient for me in my life. That all those things that I hoped for, dreamed about, thought were more important, that God had a different plan. And that His plan was always better because it always led me closer to Him. And when I was at my breaking point, when I was discouraged, when I was weak or struggling in any way, that's when I realized my strength. Because it was then when I turned to the Lord. Brothers and sisters, today I am more confident in God's presence in my life and relying on Him because of that relationship that began so many years ago. And it's been an ongoing treasure for me when I realize that in those times of weakness, when I turn to the Lord, things just start happening in His favor and favorably for me. It is true, His love and His grace is enough for me. Let us pray together the words that our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Take, Lord, and receive all my liberty, my memory, my understanding, and my entire will, all that I have and possess. You have given all to me. To you, O Lord, I return it. All is yours. Dispose of it wholly according to your will. Give me only your love and your grace, for this is sufficient for me.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us in prayer today. Feel free to invite your friends to pray with us, and by all means, have a blessed day. We'll see you tomorrow.